Okay, so Huygens wanted to look at a pendulum to measure time. Let's analyze what's going on exactly with a pendulum. Well, a pendulum is just a mass on a rod. And when we pull it back like we have here, away from the equilibrium position, which I've drawn in dotted lines, well, it's going to swing back and forth. And if there's no friction or air resistance, it'll just do that forever. Well, we expect this pendulum to give us simple harmonic motion, which means we expect that when we work out the forces and the acceleration, we want to get some acceleration that looks like minus something times x. So let's look at the forces and see if we can get that, because we want to understand what's going on here. Well, let's imagine pulling our pendulum back by some angle theta. Well, of course, our pendulum has some mass, and I said simple pendulum, so what that means, I should explain, is that all of the mass is in the bob at the end, which is just some really tiny little point mass at the end, and there's no mass in the rod, and everything is going to spin or swing without friction. The pendulum has mass, or weight, pointing down, and, well, there's only one other force. That's the force of tension supplied by the string or rod. Well, I know that when I release this pendulum, if I've pulled it back here and I release it, it's going to swing this way, down back towards the equilibrium. So actually what we want to do is break this mg into a component this way that will balance the tension and a component in this direction. This picture is starting to get a little cluttered, so let me pull it off to the side and make it a little bigger. Well, I can see that this angle is the same as this angle was over here. And if that's the case, well, I can do my trig. This is a right triangle with a hypotenuse. And there's this side, which is mg cosine theta. This side's pretty uninteresting because I know it's going to exactly balance tension. How do I know that? Well, because the mass never accelerates towards the pivot point or away. It only accelerates perpendicular, directly back towards the equilibrium point. And that force that's doing this acceleration is mg times the sine of theta. Okay, so this is the force. Actually, I should say that it's negative. Because, well, if I pull it back to the left, I would normally call that a negative angle. And the force is to the right. So this negative sign is actually important. Okay, so we have this force doing our acceleration, minus mg sine theta. Let's use our good old friend F equals ma. Well, in this case, minus mg sine theta equals ma. Oh, and check it out, the m's cancel. And we're left with this, that the acceleration is equal to minus g times the sine of theta. And we're in a bit of a pickle here because, uh-oh, this does not look like a equals minus something times x. Have no fear. We're going to do some sly massaging of this equation to figure out what's going on.